In late March, the Norfolk Senior Club held a remembrance lunch and ceremony for Evelyn Thomas Butts. Family and friends gathered at the Norview Community Center to honor and tell stories of the Norfolk native who fought for equality in Norfolk, regardless of skin color or income level. Butts was active in numerous civic community and political organizations and received countless awards for her service. One of her greatest accomplishments was standing up to the Virginia poll tax. In November 1963, Butts, who was an unemployed seamstress, filed a lawsuit challenging the constitutionality of Virginia's $1.50 poll tax, a fee required of voters at the time, which she could not afford. The case made it to the U.S. Supreme Court in 1965, and in March 1966, the U.S. Supreme Court voted 6-3 to eliminate the poll tax. After the decision, Butts said the victory was an accomplishment, not just for poor blacks, but also for poor whites who could not afford to pay the tax. Other accomplishments included her appointment as the first black woman commissioner to the Norfolk Redevelopment and Housing Authority in 1975. In November, the city of Norfolk even named a street in her honor.
But I think if we were to really think about it right now in terms of what can we see today that we can tie right back to the work of Evelyn T. Butts, I think we can go straight to the White House. The truth of the matter is we would not have a Barack Obama in the White House today if we didn't have an Evelyn T. Butts and Women of Virginia's Third Force and the SCLC and the NAACP and all the organizations that she was a part of and led, actively involved with the poll tax case and actively involved with getting people registered to vote. It is still legendary that Mrs. Butts registered more people to vote in the Commonwealth of Virginia than any single individual that people can find in the entire country. You hear what I'm saying? Registered more people to vote than anyone else in the entire country. And so she laid that framework, she laid that background so that we would see many years later Barack Obama be able to rise to be president of the United States, or for that matter, Doug Wilder being able to rise to be the governor here in Virginia.
Butts was the mother of three daughters and took great interest in public school and fought against injustices in the Norfolk school system. She died in 1993, but her memory and legacy lives on, a testimony to the many people who showed up to honor and thank her.
It really warmed my heart. I almost started crying, you know, to see so many of the older people who still honor her for the things that she has done. You know, even having a street named after her in Oakwood. I mean, and to see all of these people, it was really great.